My research revolves around three themes: entrepreneurship, family business, and telecommuting. If one had to think about a theme that revolves around these three, it is about these are the context where the two most important things in our life, Leben und Arbeiten, love and work, clash and collide. So these are the three contexts which form the research areas. My past experience has motivated me to conduct research in this area. I worked in IT startups before I came into academia, and so I became interested in entrepreneurship. And the thing that I got interested in was how do people take their passion, synthesize them, and find opportunities to start their own businesses? The key research questions are about why is it that only some people and not everybody can see an opportunity, shape it, and start his or her own business? What are the processes, sub-processes involved in this? And on the flip side, what are the challenges associated with it? What makes a business owner want to quit the business he or she has started? So that's one area that I'm really interested in. When it comes to family business, I think that is the key example of where you truly work with your loved ones and work in family, your love and your work mixed together. So the key question for family business research is, how does the dynamics of love, the dynamics of family, affect the dynamics of business? And that is, again, my core research area. Family businesses are not all the same. They come in all different shapes and sizes. But if you want to define a family business, we have to define it along dimensions of control, of dimensions of ownership, and the third dimension is the participation of family members. That includes intergenerational succession. So ownership, control, and family participation are the three key dimensions, and different family business may have different configurations of these. So they may vary along the continuum of familiness. I'm so glad you asked that question. It's been in the newspapers a lot. First, it was the Yahoo that stopped the practice of telecommuting, and now I've been hearing that HP has also jumped onto the bandwagon of not telecommuting. And here we are talking about telecommuting as an option for promoting flexibility at workplace and promoting work-family balance. So what's going on there? And the way there I look at it is that telecommuting can have tremendous benefits for flexibility for the employee and also for the organization. But the key is you have to ensure that the employee, the telecommuting employee, is not professionally isolated. Professionally isolated from organizational culture, organization's resources, and also the organization's support system. If you can promote flexibility while keeping that connection between the employee and the organization, then you can really make telecommuting work. It's not one and zero, but maintaining a balance between flexibility and connection between the organization and the employee. There are three points that I want to emphasize. From my entrepreneurship research, we know that entrepreneurship involves recognizing, shaping, and implementing an opportunity. And when an individual does that, she is doing all these three things, coming up with an idea, shaping it, and implementing it all by herself, maybe with the help of a team. But organizations have a tremendous advantage here. They can stagger the teams. They can assign these three different tasks to different people and really be entrepreneurial about the process of coming up with ideas and implementing them. So entrepreneurship can be implemented in larger organizations as well. That's going to be one takeaway point. The other takeaway point I would suggest that comes from telecommuting is maintaining the connection between the organization and employee while maintaining the flexibility. So creating that balance going forward is going to be very important for organizations. And finally, the most ubiquitous organizational form, the family business. The takeaway point from my research for them would be the family relationships and managing the emotion and the family relationships are going to be key success factors for ensuring success and survival of your family business. So while you pay attention to the business, don't neglect the family dynamics.